Hello. Hi. My name is Aldo Tolino, and I talked about user-generated content from gamers. And I coined the term ludic artifacts, which describes user-generated content, videos, images, pictures, websites that are made by gamers. And in Austria, I think quite few people know that this scene is quite productive. And during my dissertation, I tried to give an extensive summary, an overview over user-generated artifacts by gamers. And these artifacts are subsumed in six different categories: construction, then expression, performance, community, documentation, and competition. And I tried to illustrate how computer game players manage to not only play games, but also to transcend the games, go beyond the games, and produce media artifacts which are really valuable for a subculture of gamers and are produced together with a community of gamers.
But do those creators, don't they end up as extended consumers, basically? Like, they work for the game they've been fiddling with, and then they're just part of the marketing campaign, in a way?
There is a lot of discourse going on, especially in the modding scene. You have to distinguish between two types of artifacts. The type I talked about were artifacts which are not meant to be played. They are made to play a level, for example. The artifacts I mentioned in my talk were artifacts which leave the sphere of the game or want to support the game, but not a game level would not be a ludic artifact. For example, if a player makes a Counter-Strike map, it would not be a ludic artifact. In this modding scene, you mentioned there is a lot of discourse going on whether all the work that goes into these levels and all this work goes into modifications is valued or is even sold by the company. So there is a lot of discourse going on concerning this topic. The first person shooter like Quake could be a speedrun, for example. A speedrun is the aim to make a record, beating a time, and record this, and the recording, the video clip of this recording distributed over the net would be an artifact. It can also be costumes, or even, for example, if a user makes or a player makes a tutorial for a guidance how to make better gameplay or to make maps. These tutorials are also ludic artifacts because they're from gamers, products which support the game or other players. These Rube Goldberg machines are quite often to find, and especially with Half-Life 2, because the game physics are really advanced. And I also wanted to show this example, Fish and Vice, in comparison, but I thought it would be take too long. But it's an interesting question. Especially these physics simulations leave very much room for gamers to experiment. And these chain reactions are also quite funny to watch because there are things exploding and crushing up and tumbling down. And they're also really interesting example with the Crysis engine, because the Crysis engine is really quite fast and high detailing. And there are also levels where 40,000 barrels of oil collapse and you can see them tumbling down. So that's also an interesting point, because this would be things that have nothing to do with reality. And that's the main part of the skill of a game, that you can produce scenes that are not real. They don't want to reenact reality, but they want to extend this reality. They don't want to be as close to reality as they can be, but it can be fun to have, I don't know, 40,000 barrels crushing along. This has nothing to do with reality.